Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another gameplay episode of Meta Bros here on Channel Fireball. I'm Moldy Potion. This is my bro, Metacrax.
Welcome back, guys.
Welcome back, everybody. And today we are battling some new spellbooks we've constructed. I'm playing an updated Wilderness Flame spellbook that's based mostly around nice mid-range flame beasties, headless coal miners, piazza birds, and then a bunch of removal to keep things going in between. What are you playing today?
Well, I had a cosmic deck that you actually built,
right.
In the past week I've modified it a pretty good deal. I'm not going to list all the cards I changed, but I feel a little more comfortable playing this. It's still 40 pages. It's based around the lizard people alien that he is an alien, right? The lizard person?
Yes.
Okay. Which allows you for only two aura, you guys will see this, to go get another alien from your spell book and put in your chapter. So it's almost like a mini bookmark to a card that counts, specifically a beastie. Whereas, you know, normal bookmark is great, but you could draw just more aura you don't need or terror you already have.
Yep.
This gets you in the arena, in action, immediately. However, they're pretty small beasties in general and easy to remove. So far, he has been winning most of the games we play, but with this latest modification, I did take the last one. So hopefully we'll get a good game in for you guys and you'll get to see most of the mechanics in these two spellbooks.
They're both badass decks. This one, I just happened to get really lucky. Like every game that we played, my opening hand was absurdly good. And then the one game where I got a like average opening hand, he won.
Just cut you down.
Yep.
This is low cost, quick roll out, going wide, whereas
very consistent.
Whereas his is bigger beasties and removal, building up the aura to get out those coal miners, to get out the barbecue Sam, who, by the way, now with MetaZoo's latest rules, you can say that you live in the United States, and so now Father Sam also has fleet and unblockable.
It's crazy, guys. Age is now a factor as well, so Balancing Beam is back in terms of competitive play. The Caster Cup is totally going to be accepting age as a variable. Balancing Beam, if you don't know, it deals 10 times the in damage, 10 times the years between you and the opposing caster. So me and him are 6 years apart. That means that if we busted out a Balancing Beam, it would deal 60 damage. It's pretty awesome because it's a neutral direct damage spell that can be played in any deck. Also, at the tournament, you're allowed to now, instead of just having a plant for your fourth wall or the word plant on your fourth wall list, you can actually bring a bonsai tree to the tournament. And if you do that, not only does it count as a plant, but it counts as a real tree, which allows you to contract Wood Devil, one of the best beastie Sasquatches in the game, for two neutral R, which is why we each have a Wood Devil in our deck.
Yes, technically, we don't physically have the bonsai tree yet. It has been ordered from Amazon.
It's
we
on
are
the way.
Fictitiously allowing each other to play to the spellbook's full capacity, as it will be at the Caster's Cup. But you will need to have a physical, live bonsai or a tree of some sort. You know, there are like, there's like junipers and weeping willows. There's a bunch of mini trees you can get on Amazon and on Etsy. They're not the prettiest when they arrive. They really need to be, you know, groomed and well cared for. But hey, it technically is a tree, and it'll get you Wood Devil for two neutral in any spellbook.
Yeah,
absolutely
worth it. So any of you out there that are building decks for Caster's Cup, put Wood Devil in there. If you have any space in your deck that can fit a Wood Devil, it's one of the best beasties in the game. It's basically a board wipe if you get Power Up Red on him, and I highly suggest throwing him in there, because two neutral for a normally five-cost beastie is insane.
Yes, it is. And with that, before we get into the actual game, if you guys happen to be shopping at Channel Fireball and you feel like supporting us, you could use the code MetaBros with a Z at checkout. It doesn't cost you anything, but it does help us out.
Absolutely. And if you'd like more MetaZoo content from us, you can go check out our own YouTube channel, which is MetaBros with a Z. And if you'd like to support us directly, you can go to patreon.com/MetaBros with a Z. Sign up for any of those tiers. We do merch giveaways and art giveaways at the end of every month, help you guys build your spell books, all kinds of fun stuff. Big shout out to our patrons. You guys are amazing. We love you. Thank you for all the support.
Yeah, seriously. You guys make the world go round for us.
You do.
Absolutely incredible.
You do.
Okay. Okay, elbow in.
Elbow in.
Excellent. I will flip to see who goes first here in this new game. I got ahead, so you
That'll
take it away.
Me. Yep.
Yep. One, two, three.
We have a permanent choice on heads and tails flips. He is permanently tails.
We're only saying that
heads
now after almost a year of...
Yeah, if you haven't caught on.
I'm always tails.
Okay.
Yeah,
sure.
I'll play. Sure. Exactly. That's a nice part about this spellbook. You can take almost any hand you have an aura, because the most expensive beastie in here is like a 4-cost, I believe.
Yeah, yeah. That spell book, that's what we mean when we say it's consistent. You can keep almost any hand and it's going to work out. Because once Lizard People hits, you start accessing more and more beasties. You could just go get another Lizard People and
which
go
is,
get
that's,
another
that's
Lizard
my
People.
Move. And yeah. You get 5 Lizard People total, I believe.
6, actually. Yeah.
And it's you have 6
awesome.
In here?
I did.
Okay,
yeah.
I didn't take any of those out. So yeah, that's incredible. 2-cost,
it's amazing.
Get another beastie,
yep.
Remove a card from your spell book, basically a bookmark. Anyway.
All right. I'm going to get us started. I already bookmarked for my turn. I'll bring a Flame Aura into the arena and an Unending Fire Crystal.
Here he comes.
Off to a good start. I'll pass turn.
He can have the Coal Miner out next turn if he has another aura.
That's true.
Actually, Coal Miner is how much cost?
Coal Miner costs 4. Yep.
Yeah.
So that's
right.
What you're hoping with this spell book. You really are hoping you get to drop an Aura Fact turn 1 and then get something fat out turn 2.
Okay. I bookmarked. I placed a Cosmic Aura in the arena and I brought out a Kinderhook Blob.
Okay.
Who, if you guys are not familiar, Kinderhook Blob was new to Nightfall. You can have 6 per spell book. I'm only playing 2 in this. The contraction cost is 1 Cosmic. The life points are 35. 10 bonus to the life points if the Stars Terror is in play. And 10 bonus to the Forest Terror. 10 bonus life points if the Forest Terror is in play.
There
we go. And why are they giving Kinderhook life points? Because Kinderhook actually gets an attack bonus based off his life points. Fourth wall effect, this page gains plus 10 LP if you are wearing any white clothing. I am, so I get that. It would also be on my fourth wall list at any tournament. Pasty Menace is the attack, dealing X damage. X is this page's current LP. So currently, Kinderhook, with the bonus from the white clothing, has 45 LP, so he will be hitting for 45 damage. If I were to power up red Kinderhook and give him an additional 100 life points and 100 extra damage, that would mean that suddenly he was hitting for 245 total, because he'd have that 100 extra damage, which would be his base suddenly, plus the X cost, which would be his total life points added on to his damage. Big swinger.
It's crazy, guys.
Starts off small. Hopefully we'll get to use him. Grow the blob. Pass turn.
All right. I will bookmark a page. We'll bring another Flame Aura in the arena. I'll awaken my side of the arena. Wish I had a Coal Miner. It's okay. I don't. I got something that's pretty good anyway. I'm going to generate 4 and contract
Pieza.
Iowa Dragon.
Oh, man.
This is a new dragon with the Wilderness set. This guy does a lot of work. Iowa Dragon is a beastie dragon. Go figure. You can have 3 per spellbook. He costs 1 neutral, 3 flame aura. He has 65 LP. He has the flight trait, so he can only be targeted with attacks by other beasties with flight, so Kinderhook won't be able to reach Iowa Dragon. He gets a 20 damage bonus from the Desert Terra, a 15 damage bonus from the Ground Terra. When you contract Iowa Dragon, deal 25 damage to target opposing caster, inflict that caster and their beasties with 2 burn.
Wow.
Now that's going to help me, because that means if he decides to attack with Kinderhook next turn, Kinderhook will lose 20 life points and therefore 20 of his attack damage, which will help me out. Incinerate is Iowa Dragon's attack. It inflicts 3 burn, it deals 50 damage, and if the primary defender this combat already has a burn indicator, increase the primary defender's burn counters by 2. This is the only card as of this point where you can actually start to stack burn indicators and get beyond 6, which up until now has kind of been the max. So he's out. I'll deal you 25 damage. You and Blob are burned, and I'll pass turn.
All right, take that 25 damage. I'll count the burn down to 1 on both the Blob and me. Bookmark, awaken, place a Cosmic Aura in the arena, generate, 2 to contract Lizard People.
Okay.
Here we go, guys. So, Lizard People, 6 per spellbook, contraction cost 2, Cosmic, life points 50. An additional 25 bonus to the attack if the Stars are in play. Upon contraction, search your spellbook for a beastie alien and place it in your chapter. Now, new rules to Wilderness state that you must reveal any card that you search for,
yep,
unless an effect states otherwise, like you do not have to reveal it, but
right,
it's just assumed. So I will be doing that in a moment. Ambush is the attack, base damage 25. You may look at the top page of your spellbook. So, of course, Kinderhook is awakened. I'm not going to attack with Kinderhook. I have a feeling I'm unfortunately going to lose Kinderhook. I mean, you'll be able to attack anyone you want with your Iowa Dragon.
I will.
I don't know. The thing with Kinderhook is if I attack right now with his 45 life points, he'll immediately lose 20 life points from being burned, and he'll only end up dealing
25 damage.
25 damage.
Yep.
I could throw that 25 damage at the crystal, and I will.
Okay. Yeah,
why not?
I think that's a smart move.
Yeah, exactly. So he just lost 20 life. We mark loss of life with damage dice.
And you lose 20 life as well.
And I lose 20 life as well, of course. And with that, I will search for my beastie, and just to make this game quicker, turn.
Okay. I'll bookmark while he is searching there.
I mean, you know I'm getting a lizard person. That's all I'm doing.
I have to assume.
All right, cool.
I'll awaken.
Now, and my burns are gone. They count down at the end of turn, so Kinderhook and I are no longer burned.
Yep, guys, going to get another lizard people is kind of the move, because you will just continue to be able to search for more beasties, getting them out, even if they're lizard people. Lizard people are a great beastie. 50 LP, when the stars come out, they're going to swing for 50, and they let you look at the top page of your spell book. There's a lot of cool stuff going on there.
And just to let you guys know, and he knows that this is coming, the goal of this is, for me, is to get my lizard people lineup out, and then the moment I have four aura, bring out my reptoid ruler, who has fleet, and I can immediately fatigue him to use the power, giving tribal boost to all my aliens. Yep. So suddenly for every alien I have in the arena, I'm getting plus 10 damage and plus 10 life points to all other aliens.
It's so nasty. I have to stay in front of it. That's the strategy when you're up against the aliens, is you got to stay up in front and keep on destroying them before they go too wide. So I dropped an aura. I will generate 3 flame aura and contract Piazza Bird. We've been working on my dragon's roar. That's not very good. I had a deeper one, but then I started trying to channel the T-Rex from Jurassic Park, which kind of sounds like a trumpet or
like
a horn.
Even Game of Thrones. Like, yeah, there's like a longer sustain, I believe, with the like.
There you go. There you go. Well, anyway, you have to roar like a dragon or else you destroy this page when you contract it.
Are we counting your roar like a dragon? I'm kidding. I accept.
Yes, we're counting it. Okay. I did it to the best of my ability, guys. Beastie Dragon is the beastie type. He is Piazza Bird, same as the other one. You can have one per spell book of this variant of Piazza Bird. He costs 3 flame aura, has 90 LP, has flight like his fellow dragons, gets a 20 damage bonus from the Suburban Terra, a 20 damage bonus from the City Terra. I already told you the contract effect. You got to roar like a dragon. Flame Spiral is the attack that deals 60 damage. It inflicts 6 burn counters. And if you have 100 or less LP, this attack deals plus 60 damage. He's just a great value beastie for 3, man. That's one of the best 3 drops you can hope for.
If you only had to pick one, who would you have, Iowa or Piazza?
I think Iowa, because that burning everything effect when
it's
he
crazy,
contracts
man.
Is so good. Yeah, it's so good. It helps to slow down the opponent, especially if they're playing tokens or something. And then I'm going to generate 2 and contract Explosion.
Ah, here we go.
This is the best flame spell in the game, guys. Yep. That's so amazing. It came out in Wilderness. You can have 4 per spell book. It costs 2 flame aura. Target beastie or caster is dealt 50 damage and is inflicted with burn. Target beastie or caster is dealt 10 damage and is inflicted with burn. This may be the same target as before. You, me, lose 25 LP. So I'm going to lose 25 LP, but I'll deal 50 to lizard people.
Yep.
And I'll deal 10 to Kinderhook, and I'll burn him again.
Yep.
Burn, I'm going to roll for burn.
Go redhead.
Mm-hmm. We got a 1 on there.
All right, we'll take that.
So I guess I'll just finish Kinderhook with Iowa.
I knew that was coming.
And then
okay,
I take 25, like I said, and I will pass turn.
All right, bookmark. He's cleared my arena. This is an issue for us, guys. I'm not going to give up, but essentially, he has arena control. All my beasties will be smaller. They will not be able to reach the flyers. And because I need attackers to remove his beasties, there's a very good chance he's going to take this game already.
Yep.
Like after the first turn, second turn, you just know. The opposite has happened where I get in the lead immediately and I have arena control. But
yep.
In this case, we'll just play through and see what happens. So I think I place another Cosmic Aura in the arena.
Yes.
I will generate 2 to contract another lizard people, and I will search for them again to speed up the game in a moment. I'll also generate 1 to contract a Schmooze.
Ooh,
now,
nice.
Schmooze might actually help us out a little bit, unless he has some direct damage, which he probably does. Medford Schmooze, 8 per spellbook, contraction cost 1 cosmic, life points 35, has the flash trait, so upon entering the arena, I flip a coin and target a beastie, and if successful, if I flip a heads, that beastie cannot attack next turn. Which one is dealing more damage?
Technically, Piazza deals more damage. Piazza swings for 60 and 6 burn. Iowa Dragon swings for 50 and 3 burn.
Then, in this case, I will be targeting Piazza.
Okay.
And we got a tail, so there will be no flash.
She
will be able to attack, but that's not all the Schmooze do.
True.
They get an additional 10 life points if the Forest Terra is in play, and 10 to the attack if the Stars Terra is in play. Arena effect. When you contract a light page, create a Schmooze token with 10 LP, cosmic beastie with 10 damage attack. That's great if you're playing light. We're not doing a dual or spellbook, so that doesn't apply in this case. If this beastie was destroyed by another beastie in combat, inflict that beastie with sleep. So I have a 50-50 chance to flip a coin. If successful, sleep the beastie for the rest of the game. White spores is the attack, base damage 15, also inflicting sleep upon a successful flip. With that, I will pass turn and go look for another lizard people.
Okay. I will bookmark a page. Yeah, guys, the schmooze have to make me think a little bit because he's going to get, even if I just attack and destroy his schmooze right now, he's going to get a sleep trigger that might shut down one of my beasties for potentially the rest of the game. And although I have some really strong beasties, I don't have a lot of them right now.
Kind of the rest of the game. The thing with the flame spellbook specifically and having these bigger dragons with more life points, when you're asleep, you can't wake up unless someone targets you with an attack or deals you direct damage, like from a spell or a power. If damage is dealt, it actually doubles the damage. And as you just saw, he has spells where he can deal just 10 damage to one of his beasties, therefore dealing 20 damage if they're asleep and removing the status effect indicator, allowing them to attack with a little loss of life. It's not a big deal.
No, yeah. Explosion's crazy good for that because it isn't target opposing beastie. The target can be any beastie or caster, so you can deal the 50 damage to an opposing beastie, and then, like you just said, I can deal the 10 damage to one of my sleeping beasties to wake him up if I want. Let's see, though. I dropped an aura already. I'll generate 5 and contract Hell's Gate, which is kind of the biggest artifact that I've ever really used in the game. It's pretty expensive. It costs 2 neutral, 3 flame aura, but it has 100 LP, so it tends to hang around. You can have 1 per spellbook. It has the convert trait, so when it's awakened, I can fatigue it to generate a flame aura, but this thing has some crazy effects. While it's in the arena, you may contract flame beasties from your limbo, and they gain fleet. All beasties you controlled that are destroyed while Hell's Gate is in the arena go to afterlife. Portal of Flames is the power. Flame beasties you control gain 25 LP and their attacks deal plus 25 damage until the end of this turn. Now, it's not the smartest move to bring this out before I have beasties in my limbo. Typically, the play is to wait till your beasties are in limbo and then you can bring them back with Hell's Gate. But what I'm trying to do right now is actually just use this more for the buff effect, where I'll be able to keep on adding life points onto my beasties and making their attacks deal an extra 25 damage that turn. The life point gain will be permanent. The attack damage will only be for that turn. All right, I will...
Now, when it says contract, you still have to pay for the beastie, but they come out with fleet.
Yes, but none of these guys are going to go to my limbo now because Hell's Gate is out. That's why I'm saying it's smarter to wait to play Hell's Gate.
Yeah, until you have them in your limbo because they'll be sent to your afterlife and therefore cannot be affected.
Exactly, but I'm committing to an aggressive strategy at this point because I have a good arena control. I have a good setup, so I'm just going balls to the walls trying to deal as much damage as possible. So I will attack your lizard people with Piazza for 60.
All right, died.
And I'll attack Schmooze with Iowa Dragon for 50,
okay,
and we'll see if I
coin.
Sleep.
Failed. Oh no, guys. This is pretty much over for me.
Yep, that was a crucial flip right there. I will pass turn.
Okay, bookmark, awaken, place another aura in the arena, generate 4 to contract 2 more lizard people.
Okay.
I'll search for 2 more lizard people and pass turn.
Okay. I'm going to bookmark a page and awaken my side of the arena here. I will bring another flame aura into the arena and generate 1, 2, 3, 4 to contract Headless Coal Miner.
I'm revealing 2 Fresno Nightcrawlers.
Nice, nice. So I contracted Headless Coal Miner. This is kind of my favorite beastie in the spellbook. He is so nasty. He's a beastie spirit. You can have 3 per spellbook. He costs 1 neutral, 3 flame aura. He has 50 LP. He has the spirit trait, which means that he can't be targeted by attacks, period. He can be blocked, but he can't be targeted by attacks. He gets a 25 damage bonus from the Mountain Terra and from the Nighttime Terra, and this page's attacks deal plus 25 damage if there is coal within eyesight. That is a fourth wall item on the official fourth wall list, so you can just list coal as a fourth wall and he'll get that 25 plus damage. Though, if you want to do this at Caster Cup, you need to actually have some coal with you. The contract effect, you create 2 dynamite tokens, which are 10 LP flame artifacts with the effect, when this artifact is destroyed, deal 20 damage to target caster. Fiery Pick is his attack. It inflicts 3 burn, deals 50 damage. It'll be 75, like I said. And then destroy all dynamite tokens in the arena as an attack effect. Deal 10 damage to all opposing pages for each dynamite Dynamite token destroyed. So he's like a wipe and a nasty big swinging beastie all rolled up in one. It's really amazing. I will generate...
Especially when he works with Hell's Gate.
Yes, and Hell's Gate is actually awakened at this point. I'll generate two. And
what about your Dynamite tokens?
Good call. We'll bring those in the arena. There's my Dynamite tokens. I will also contract the Wood Devil for aura. So Wood Devil, Beastie, Sasquatch, one per spell book, costs two neutral, three forest normally, but only costs two neutral if a real tree is within eyesight. So that would be what our bonsai tree counts as. By the way, if one player has a bonsai tree, it counts for both players, just so you know.
By the way, if you're at a tournament, you can even see someone who has a bonsai tree. I mean, don't take the risk.
That depends on the tournament.
Bring your own.
Yeah, that depends on the tournament rules. 75 LP is his max. He also has the trap trait and the convert trait, so he can be set as a trap underneath beasties, or he can be fatigued to generate an aura of the forest type. He gets a 25 damage and a 25 life point bonus from the Forest Terra. This page gains first strike if it was flipped face up as a trap this combat. Devilish Scream is the attack. It inflicts paralyzed, deals 25 base damage, and you may distribute this attack's damage to any number of beasties, artifacts, or casters. Minimum of 5 damage per target. That's why he's crazy, because you can attack anywhere you want in the arena. I could attack him, and then I can just send the damage elsewhere. I can send it to beasties who you can't normally attack. You could send it to flying beasties, spirit beasties, whatever it may be.
Magi proof, all of it.
Yep. So Wood Devil is out. I'm going to fatigue my Hell's Gate to give all my flame beasties plus 25 LP.
This is going to be a short life.
This is getting pretty nasty. I'm going to just mark their LP bonuses here so I don't forget. And they also have 20 plus 25 damage till the end of this turn.
Wait, that's their LP bonus? Do me a favor. Let's use something on Hell's Gate.
Sure.
So we've got 25 life point bonus there.
All right. That sounds good to me.
Thank you.
I will... The question is, do I just start hitting him or do I pay attention to these lizard people? At this point, I don't really think the lizard people are that big of a threat, especially because most of my beasties can't even be touched. So I'm just going to swing straight at him. I'll hit you first with Piazza Bird for 6 burn and 85 damage.
Yeah. This game is going to be wrapped very quickly. You got me.
Yeah. Okay. I'll mark the damage there. Boom, boom, boom. Mm-hmm. And then I will attack you with Iowa Dragon to increase the burn by two.
Yep, you got me. 8
and
burn.
He will deal 75 damage.
Okay.
Pass turn.
All right. Bookmark. I just bookmarked from my own hand.
Bookmark from
Let's try
my
that
chapter.
Bookmark. There we go. Burn counts down to 7. So pathetic.
That's a lot of burn.
That's too much burn. That's too much tuna, guys. All right. So... Yeah, there's not much that we can do here. There's very little, actually, we can do here. We'll generate 3, and we'll transfiguration the Piazza Bird.
Okay.
This was actually a spell from Cryptid Nation and then reprinted in Nightfall, I believe, or was it Wilderness? Regardless, 4 per spell, but contraction cost, 3 cosmic. Target beastie loses all traits. Fourth wall, symbols, recovers its maximum LP, and becomes a neutral type beastie sheep with 10 maximum LP and 10 damage attack until the end of the caster's next turn. All right, caster's next turn. So it's a little sheep thing. I'll attack it and kill it with the lizard people.
You got it.
I probably should have done that to the Wood Devil, but I don't think I'm going to win this game. I lose 20 life points for the attack. I guess I'll send... 25 damage also to I don't even know who to send it to. They're just gonna die. I'll save him as a blocker. Never mind. Turn.
Okay. All right. I'll bookmark a page, awaken my side of the arena here.
Just trying to think, do I have really any options to get me out of this? I don't think so. I'm like overwhelmed.
Yeah, this is probably one of the hardest rollouts of this spellbook that we've seen. I'm going to fatigue Hell's Gate, so I will add another 25 LP to my beastie's life points, and they will all deal an additional 25 damage this turn.
Oh, yeah.
So that's a 50. And then I will attack... I guess I'll attack... You with Headless Coal Miner for 75, popping the dynamite tokens and dealing 20 damage to each of your beasties,
man,
and 40 damage to you.
You got me. All that happens. No reason to try to stop it. I mean, all I could do is block and lose a beastie and damage just go roll over. Okay. What else?
All right. I'm going to lightning in a bottle him and just swing again for 75.
You got me again. Okay.
And then actually it's for 100, right? Because of Hell's Gate.
The 25 bonus.
Yep. And then I'll swing at you for 75 with Iowa Dragon.
Oh, you got me again.
And increase your burn counters by 2.
So I'm at 8 again.
This is crazy, guys. Iowa Dragon just keeps you permanently burned. So anytime you attack at all, you're losing life. And then I'll swing. Sure. I'll swing with Wood Devil as well. He does not have a damage bonus. He's swinging for 25 damage.
Okay.
Are you blocking?
No, there's no point. You just kill my beastie.
Okay. I'll just deal the 25 damage to you.
Okay, you got me.
And pass turn.
Bookmark. Awaken. Oh my gosh. They all have 50 additional life, the Flame Beasties.
The Flame Beasties do, yes.
Whoa.
So Headless Coal Miner has 100, Iowa Dragon has 115. Yeah. Hell's Gate's crazy.
Okay.
Oh, and Piazzabird's technically not in limbo. He goes to
Afterlife.
Afterlife.
1, 2, 3. We will transfiguration the Iowa Dragon.
Okay.
And then attack him with one of the lizard people.
All right, you got him.
Killing Iowa Dragon. Let's see, that's 3 aura we use. We have one more. Can't really do much else, so yeah, turn.
Okay. I'll bookmark a page, awaken my side of the arena. I'll generate 5 and contract Father Sam, Barbecue Revolutionary. So this spellbook just continues to roll out so nastily.
There's
today.
No hope.
He costs 2 neutral, 3 flame R. You can have 1 per spellbook. He has 100 LP. He gets a 25 damage bonus from the Daytime Terra and a 20 LP bonus from the Suburban Terra. If you live in the USA, this is a valid fourth wall effect now. This page gains unblockable and fleet, and his attack, Freedom Feeding, deals 125 damage. Inflicts burn and creates a friendly barbecue token, which is a 25 LP flame beastie with a destroyed effect and the self-destruct, meaning I can fatigue it on my turn, destroy it, and then the destroyed effect is target beastie recovers 25 LP and loses all traits until the end of this turn. This card is my favorite flame beastie in the game. He is so good, and especially now that he has fleet and unblockable, it's not looking good for my bro. I'm going to fatigue Hell's Gate and just move to 75. Bonus LP my flame beasties. I'll mark Sam separately because he only has 25.
The only help I have, and the window for, you know, life points is closing quickly, especially after this turn, is I draw 2 more transfigurations, and then I basically get a big beastie of my own, but I only have 2 in the Wood Devil and the Reptoid, and the ruler doesn't do much. Right. Well, I could take him over. I could try to.
You could.
We'll see.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, that's true.
That's a long shot, though, and I'm cards away from even beginning to defend myself.
Right. I feel like at this point, I've already lost 2 beasties of transfiguration, so I'm going to clear the arena. I'll just attack each lizard person with my flame beasties.
They die.
And then I'll hit you for 25.
Okay.
And pass turn.
Yeah, you should have hit me with Father Sam, and you should have attacked with the Wood Devil, the one of my beasties, dealing me far more damage.
He wouldn't have killed your beastie, though. He only swings for 25.
5?
Yeah, your lizard people have 50.
5 life points, you're right.
Yep.
Okay, you pass turn?
Yep.
Okay, I count my burn down to 6, I believe. Yeah.
That's crazy.
This is insane. And I bookmark and awaken, place the stars in the arena. Life points on your flame beasties currently?
Headless Coal Miner has 125. Father Sam has 125.
Insane, guys.
Yeah.
Wood Devil?
Wood Devil has 75.
Oh, man. So, geez, everybody. All right. I'll generate 4, and I'll contract 2 Fresno Nightcrawlers.
Okay.
So Fresno Nightcrawlers came out in Cryptid Nation. You can have 2 per spellbook. Contraction cost 2 cosmic. Life points 40. Has the spirit trait, so they cannot be targeted by attacks. Have the fleet trait, so they can attack immediately or use a power if they had one. Gets an additional 25 bonus to the attack if the Nighttime Terror is in play. Fourth wall effect. This beastie cannot be contracted if you are wearing pants. Got the shorts on. Also my fourth wall list. We assume the best fourth wall list for the best games. When Fresno Nightcrawlers enters the arena, you may reveal any number of non-cosmic pages from your chapter and then shuffle them into your spellbook. You may then bookmark an equal number of pages from the top of your spellbook. Cosmic Orb is the attack. Base damage, 50. Do I want to take advantage of that? No, not necessarily. I mean, out of aura, I could trade in a couple of my cards and hope for transfigs. Not sure, though, if that's really the move. Probably not. Okay. So I will attack the Wood Devil, 50 damage.
Okay, yep. And Wood Devil only hits back for 25. Let me see if he gets his paralyze on your beastie.
Huh.
He failed the paralyze.
Okay.
So Wood Devil only deals 25. Your Nightcrawler is still alive.
Hit with my other Nightcrawler to kill the Wood Devil.
Yep, you got
25
him.
Damage and turn. I was thinking maybe I should attack the Hell's Gate because the problem is... actually, no, I'm good because Hell's Gate continues to send stuff to the afterlife once it's in play. That's how they power balance this ability to bring back all the beasties from Limbo. You have to have them there already.
Correct. Yeah, like I said, Hell's Gate, technically it's smarter to bring out after you already have some beasties waiting in your Limbo.
Oh, no, you're wrapping the game up.
Yeah,
man.
I mean, look at this, guys. This is rolling out heavy. I'm going to generate one New Year's New Beginnings. So we will each throw our chapter into the cemetery. I don't have a chapter to throw. And then we'll bookmark 7 new pages.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, my burn's down to 5, of course.
True.
All right.
Okay, we will generate... I guess we'll generate 1, 2, 3, 4 and contract another Iowa Dragon.
Oh, my gosh.
Deal you 25 damage and inflict 2 burn on you and your beasties. You're already burned, so you can't be burned more, but your beasties each have 2 burn. And then I will attack... Well, first, I'll use Hell's Gate, so we'll bump up. Now all my beasties have got an extra 100 life points, which is just absurd. Or at least
it is. This is impossible right now.
Yeah, this guy just got bumped up to 50 bonus.
I'm just here to show off your spellbook's mechanics, basically.
Today, yes, that's what's happening. I will attack you for 100 with Headless Coal Miner.
Yeah, me, obviously. I have nothing.
And then I will attack you for 150.
Got me, Ken.
Uncle Sam, and I will lightning in a bottle Uncle Sam and do it again.
I lost 40 life points from attacking with your 2.
You did.
Yep.
And I'm going to lightning in a bottle again. So that is game,
guys. Oh my gosh. As we started this off, like I said, he's won most of these games. When he gets that fire crystal and a couple big beasties, it is incredibly challenging to catch up, especially when you're going low cost wide like this spellbook. But similar to the light elementals, you can get out in front. It's like you're a sprinter and you really have to stay ahead. I wish this deck had more removal. Transconfiguration requires a beastie to attack and take out that, you know, reduced life point little sheep neutral thing. So I don't feel as confident in this. It's like you get lucky or you don't.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's an aggressive spellbook. Yeah. Like you play it aggressively, you have to. It's low on removal, like you said. It's hoping to go wider, quicker. But up against this spellbook, like he said, when I hit that fire crystal, it's just absurd because mid-range flame beasties are incredibly strong. Incredibly strong, as you see. They swing for a lot, they inflict burn, they have all kinds of cool attack effects. It's nasty.
Yeah, I have these little like this little gang of lizards who are like rolling out, calling each other, like with their little like suits on, you know what I mean? Like, and you've got like dragons burning, reburning, overburning. It's impressive. I'm normally the flame player, so I'm a little jealous, just being sincere.
It was fun to play.
But yeah, it was also good to try to pilot something a little different. And because he won, we will be back next week with our spellbook deck tech for the new Wilderness Revised flame deck, which is really Iowa Dragons and Coal's Gate was Nightfall, wasn't it?
Coal Miner was Nightfall
also.
Oh yeah, you mean what was new in Wilderness? Totally. Yeah. It's the Iowa Dragons is the heart of it, and then the explosion, like the spell explosion and the Iowa Dragons, just amazing.
Anyway, guys, if you made it this far, thank you so much for watching, liking, commenting. If you want more content, you can head over to our channel, Meta Bros with a Z. Hit subscribe. We just crossed 1,000 subscribers. It's the total amazing, awesome inspiration. So thank you guys for all the support. And if you're shopping at Channel Fireball and you feel like supporting us, you could use the code Meta Bros with a Z at checkout. It doesn't cost you anything, but it does help us out.
Absolutely. And like we mentioned earlier, we also have a Patreon. If you want to support us directly, go to patreon.com/MetaBros with a Z. Huge shout to our patrons. We love you all. We love everybody who's watching us. You guys are awesome. You guys are definitely awesome. Feel free to come find us on Instagram at MetaBros. Happy to help answer your questions, help you learn the game, because this is a very complex game. It's more complex than it looks like on the surface. And once you get into it, man, it is so fun.
It's super addicting. Yeah. It's hard going to other games that don't have as many mechanics and options where the cards are constantly rearranging the power values depending on how they're interacting in the Terra and the fourth wall. It's a blast. Anyway, thanks again, guys. And we will see you next time on
Meta Bros.
Later, guys.
Later, everybody.